What is the very best neutral color to use in your home? Is there a perfect grayish? Actually, I got two of them, and in this video, I'm going to compare AGREEABLE gray and EDGECOMB gray, so hopefully you can find your perfect paint color. This is going to be a tricky color clash for me to do, mainly because I have so much love for both of these colors. It's also not often that people compare colors from two different companies, but Benjamin Moore's EDGECOMB gray and Sherwin-Williams AGREEABLE gray are immensely popular midtones because of their flexibility and versatility. I encourage you to explore all paint companies' color palettes because even though it's easy to become overwhelmed sometimes, knowledge is power, and sometimes you just need to venture outside of that color palette you always seem to revert to. Kind of like me in the Affinity color palette. This is a channel that's all about painting, decorating, and color, and Color Clash is where we take two comparable colors and compare them. Funny enough. AGREEABLE gray and EDGECOMB gray, coincidentally, both have gray in their name, although it could be argued that they're much more than that. Within the neutral category of colors, there's so much variance with your tints, tones, and shades, and I would categorize both of these colors as mid-tone grayishes. They're in that mid-tone sector because of where their LRV, or light reflectance value, sits, which is right around 60. EDGECOMB gray tends to be a little bit lighter by about 3%, but they're close enough that they would be used in very similar circumstances. So yes, AGREEABLE gray is darker, but not by much. What gives them their grayish name is the fact that they utilize both gray and beige components mixed together, which as you have probably noticed over the past few years, has been an incredibly popular color category. Chances are, if you look around your home right now, you'll notice that you'll have at least some gray or beige, or both. And if you do, then a grayish wall color will usually work. But between EDGECOMB gray and AGREEABLE gray, how do you know which one of these two will work better or more optimally? That's where we can start to analyze the undertones behind these colors. Starting with Benjamin Moore's EDGECOMB gray, its gray-beige warmth is heightened by an added yellow-gold aspect, which truly warms up the color quite a bit. There is also a very subtle green interaction that can sometimes happen with yellow and gray undertones combining, but this only seems to come about in dimly lit areas or rooms that get a lot of really cool lighting, like those north-facing rooms with their subtle blue cast. AGREEABLE gray, on the other hand, has noticeably less yellow warmth within it, and we can start to see this when we put both colors behind completely white backgrounds. You can emulate this sort of effect in real life if you have a paintable board like a Mighty board that you can paint with each color and then place it against a white door you might have handy. The Mighty board will give you a nice big surface area to witness the color against a completely neutral canvas behind it, which can really show you the undertones for yourself in your own space. Another thing I'll do for you is I'll take AGREEABLE gray and EDGECOMB gray and blow them up so that they completely cover the screen side by side. If you look close enough on your screen, you should notice that EDGECOMB gray seems like it has more yellow in it. AGREEABLE gray, on the other hand, feels a bit closer to gray, but I don't necessarily think it has less yellow colorant inside. They both have a lot in common color-wise, and they're really just a mix of yellow, gray, and maybe a touch of red to give them that taupe touch. AGREEABLE gray just seems to have a little more gray, and what that translates to is a step away from EDGECOMB's beige aspect, making it feel a touch more taupe in comparison. It's a classic example of two colors that are made up of the same parts. It's just that those parts are arranged differently. Even though they go in slightly different directions, they still follow the same path, and I would use them in completely similar ways. They're both going to feel quite neutral on the walls. This is especially the case if you love to use those dynamic colors and textures within your own interior design. Let me break it down like this. If your color palette incorporates more grays, taupes, browns, purples, or reds, then I would perhaps lean you towards AGREEABLE gray. But to be honest, lately, I've been favoring the warmer tones just to keep things as uplifting as possible. So if you're like me and you love creams, gold, natural woods, copper, and of course green, then EDGECOMB gray just edges the competition. I want to make it clear though that these aren't your only two choices here. There are so many unique colors and color combinations that you can use in so many different ways. But if you do want just a bit more information on each of these colors, you can check out our color code episodes of them right over here. They're popular because they're versatile, but you also want to make sure that you're using your own design voice. So be creative, have fun, and whatever you do, do it with colorful confidence.